Hi, I'm Catherine Robertson Pilling, founder and creator of the Wheel of Creativity. One of the things I love doing is interviewing people that I know and people that I meet about their creative process. So this is going to be one of those interviews. Stay tuned and enjoy. Hi, I'm here with Carol Bruton, a very gifted artist that I've known for a long time. And we're just going to talk a little bit about Carol's creative process and the creative process in general. So Carol, tell me, what was your first painting? How did you start painting?
My very first painting was when we lived in Spain, mm-hmm. and I was about 8 years old, and we lived in a dry southern village on the Costa del Sol, mm-hmm. and I loved the traces of the houses, and one night I went and stole the sand where the builders used to make the stucco, and I used that sand in oil paint and created the look then, which was stark buildings in the south of Spain with a palette knife and oil and the sand that I had stolen. Mm. And that's how it started.
So even from the beginning, there was a bit of a technical experiment to your work.
Absolutely. I've always been interested in the materials that are local to where I'm living. Mm-hmm. And I've always been interested in reducing the amount of lines around me. So reducing it to the most simple form. And when I look at the work then, they were literally sides of buildings with tiny gaps where the windows were and a big blue sky. Mm. And I think those principles have followed me through my whole artistic life. Mm.
So flash forward to now, you're yes. living on the Côte d'Azur, and how have those principles evolved?
Well, like I said, I'm still using the local materials. I'm still fascinated by reducing the form. Mm-hmm. Because I swim all through the year, which many people find crazy, I've been able to extract from the ocean forms that are difficult to find in the summer when more people are in the sea. Mm-hmm. And the other day I experienced an octopus that was sending out bubbles of perfectly formed rounds of oxygen. Mm. And these have created the series that I'm heavily involved with at the moment, mm-hmm. to the extent that I'm using an outside manufacturer and we're working together to produce the bubble series.
Right.
But it's still very much what I've always been attracted to, a simplistic form, using materials in a different way, and creating something that hopefully is quite magnetic mm-hmm. to the viewer.
Mm. Yeah, well, I would attest to that.
So
you're, as long as I have known you, which is over 10 years now,
yeah.
I have seen you go through a process to take your idea from an idea yeah. into form that is very technical and can yeah. sometimes take years.
Yeah.
How do you manage that gap?
That to sustain it? I think I start with the premise that I feel it very strongly. I see an image, mm-hmm. I feel it very, very strongly, to the extent that I won't compromise. Mm-hmm. And that energy sustains me through to the product. And it can take, I mean, with a series that you know very well, which I was doing about 5 years ago, that took 4 years to actually
yes.
know how to produce. Mm. And that came about because when I would go under the water and flip onto my back and look through the surface of the water to the sky, mm. and see organic particles floating on the top of the sea, mm-hmm. knowing how to, I mean, just trying to work out how to do something that was not obviously man-made. And that took about 4 years. Mm-hmm. And and I was able to reduce the technique so that I can more or less do it on you know, when I wanted to. But the results are, each painting is very different. Mm-hmm. And I'm an artist that won't compromise. Once I've seen something I want to do, I'm not interested in copying anyone else or trying to find out if other people have done it my way, which means that quite often my art I have to explain to the viewer where it's come from, because it does not appear to exist anywhere else. Mm. But yes, I mean, as an art advisor told me, your work is not realistic, so you need to explain what you're doing, and it's far more difficult to mm-hmm. transmit that idea if mm-hmm. you don't actually automatically know what it is when you view the painting.
Yeah.
But I like the mystery. I like the fact people want to know how I do it. And I never actually divulge how I do it, but yeah. People do want to know.
Well, every one of us has a story. As yeah. you know, my work is around the creative process
yeah.
that is there for every individual to mm. channel, which
mm.
is really clearly what you're doing.
Mm.
And we all have a story, and we all have that process to navigate. So what would you say has kept you going through the years?
I think the one element that's kept me going is being in the sea through the winter,
mm-hmm.
because the fall in temperature produces an endorphin effect in the body, which is why people get hooked on swimming when it's cold.
Mm-hmm.
And that endorphin effect means that for those 5 minutes when you come out of the sea, you're actually able to access more or less anything you want. The technique,
right.
Where you want to show it. I mean, all the questions I have during the day get answered in those 5 minutes.
Mm.
So it is that drug, that fix. It's like being plugged into a huge source of energy.
Right.
That is what, because when I go to England and I don't have that swim, I don't have any, my energy is greatly reduced. But the winter swimming causes the energy behind
right.
the work that I do.
Mm. Well, what I hear in that from my perspective is that it opens up the channel for you to connect with the source.
Correct.
Of the idea
yeah.
and the execution, the implementation
Correct.
Of the idea.
Yeah.
And that is something I think each of us has to find our own unique method
yeah.
for connecting with source.
Yeah.
So I am wishing you so much success, as you know I always have,
yes.
and really excited to see where your work goes next, Carol.
Thank you
Thank
very much.
You.
Thank you.
Oh, super.